that ad again.
Hey, what's up, Joe?
Hey, Aurora. I wanted us to have a chat on Mars, but this disruptive ad ruined my plans.
I hear you. But I guess this nowhere land can also be a great place to discuss something we've been meaning to talk about for a while.
Hi, I'm Joe from the Google Play Academy.
And I'm Aurora from the Policy Transparency team.
Welcome to the AdMob and Play Policy Conversations, a series for Google Play developers
who also monetize their apps with AdMob specifically, or are considering it.
Aurora, do you bake?
Not very well.
Then this story might relate. Imagine you own a bakery shop.
That doesn't sound like a good idea.
And I buy a cake from your shop and find a teaspoon inside of it.
Sometimes I follow recipes quite literally.
You see, this is actually a safety issue. I could have chipped my tooth. And this error impacts the trust your customers have in the baker, supplier, or developer of your specific product, in this instance, the cake, but also the bakery store that sold it to you.
Building up on your story, despite knowing how terrible my baking skills are, also known as low quality content, I decide to let local businesses advertise themselves inside my store. Once customers like you find out about my poor quality product, you will most likely, one, have a frustrating customer experience, and two, associate those brands that are advertising in my store with it. Similarly, for apps, and to prevent this bad experience, at Google we create publisher policies and restrictions to help ensure that our users, advertisers, and publishers or developers are protected, feel valued, and can trust in the digital advertising ecosystem, or the bakery shop and its products.
Definitely, but I bet striking a balance when creating those policies is not easy. Helping publishers and developers earn revenue while helping advertisers distribute their messaging in a safe way must be a constant challenge.
It really is. Same way as you were not happy when you found the teaspoon inside your cake and complained about it, the local businesses also complained about the association of their brands to the bad quality bakery. And this affects me too, as the business owner, as anybody can make mistakes. That's why balance is the ultimate goal of our Google policies.
And that's why Google teams are constantly reviewing policies and enforcement, striving to be fair and thorough, while being mindful of societal and technological changes, as well as global events.
Yeah, because what if selling cakes with teaspoons inside them becomes trendy at some point? That way, it would be easier to get your cake and eat it with a spoon.
The foundation of everything we do is trust, and to build trust, we have to have a store free of invalid traffic and bad actors. Although I can't say much about this video being free of bad acting.
Fortunately, our policy and enforcement teams are there to ensure this. We use a combination of human and automated reviews to provide scalable, automated defenses to continuously identify, clean, and defend our ad systems.
And new app submissions are reviewed and, once accepted, occasionally re-reviewed for policy compliance.
So Joe, as an Android developer, what are some things I should consider when integrating ads into my app?
Developers choose the ad network they want to monetize their app with. There are many ad networks, and AdMob is just one of them. Google Play has a set of policies around monetization and ads to ensure the best user experience, no matter which one they decide to use. You'll want to become familiar with Play's monetization and ads policies on the Play Policy Center. And when you list your app or game that contains any ads, you would declare this in Google Play Console as you prepare your app for publishing. A Contain Ads label is shown on the store listing and is visible to all Play Store users. To do this, you'll go to your app in Google Play Console, select Policy and App Content, then under Ads, you can start this process. And remember, if you've previously published your app without ads, but are updating it with ads, you should modify this declaration to reflect this. Finally, if you serve ads in your app and the target audience for your app includes children as described in the families policy, then you must use an ads SDK that is self-certified compliance with Google Play policies when serving ads to children. These ads SDKs are part of the Family Ads Program, and you can find them in the Play Policy Center. Aurora, what do developers need to know when monetizing their app with AdMob?
There are a few things developers can consider to help protect their earnings and apps beyond what Google already does to help protect the ecosystem. Some ideas are, first of all, limit the types of ads that can appear in your app by making use of the available blocking options. In many cases, not all ads or categories are suitable for the content of your app. Also, only use ad formats that make sense for your app. Secondly, set up your AdMob account correctly and adhere to the program policies and restrictions. Third, understand your analytics. Proactively monitor your traffic and be aware of what normal traffic patterns for your app look like. By doing this, you'll be able to identify small issues before they become serious trouble. Fourth, keep an eye on the policy center in your account and use it to prioritize the most critical issues to solve. And finally, you can implement App Ads TXT. Bad actors disguise their inventory to trick ad networks into thinking they are high value. You can create your own App Ads TXT files to identify who is authorized to sell your inventory. The files are publicly available and crawlable by exchanges, supply-side platforms, SSPs, and other buyers and third-party vendors.
Aurora, what is App Ads TXT?
It's an IAB Tech Lab industry specification to publicly declare authorized inventory and help us put an end to bad actors trying to spoof your app and capitalize on your brand. It's very simple to implement, requiring as little as one line of code. We recommend checking out the full spec of instructions on file creation and hosting on the IAB Tech Lab website. Hey, Joe, can we return to Earth?
Sure. In this conversation, we introduce Google's work in nurturing a healthy and trustworthy ecosystem. We also discuss some tips to consider as you monetize your app with ads on Google Play.
Until the next time, Joe.
See ya.